Good afternoon, everybody. Hi, I'm Nilanshi Verma.
And I'm Anushree Chaudhary.
From the Patriots Badge, and we welcome you here after the short tea break. We would like to welcome our honorable guest, Ms. Anita Gupta, with a bouquet. We would request Uncle Bala to present her the Puna Day. Ms. Anita Gupta is one of the icons of the advertising industry, a highly regarded lady in the media, and a renowned and respected name in J. Walter Thompson, rebranded as JWT. A communications professional with over 25 years of wide-ranging experience in advertising on a diverse portfolio of brands such as Ford Motor Company, Tata Steel, Bata, Periwear, Lifestyle, to name a few, Ms. Anita Gupta doesn't just thrive on change, but usually spots the sign early enough to be able to harness it to the maximum potential. Combine this with a keen sense of spotting customers' insight, and it enables innovative approach to communication strategy. Her rich experience in building brands helps her understand how the totality of brand building goes beyond mere communication. As a member of JWT's executive committee, she plays an integral role in chalking out company policy, diversifications, and human resource development. We'll now request ma'am to please come on stage. We are going to launch a strategy magazine this year, so we'll now request Uncle Bala and ma'am to please inaugurate the magazine.
Before we formally launch this newsletter, I do want you to know how communication is probably the most important weapon in a successful management. If you do not have communication, I think any amount of skill set, knowledge set is not going to be there. And I am so happy that our students felt the need for this periodic communication on strategy. And let me announce, I think I told a few people, that our graduation or the convocation for this class of Patriots will be with Mr. N.S. Narayanamurthy. I think Tanushree Sharma and all other Infosys people will be delighted, but he is a legendary person, and I am glad he accepted my invitation when I had a nice dinner at his home, squatting on the ground and eating the food. You know, so that is the best time I slipped this request, and when he is my host, he cannot refuse that thing. And so again, note that communication at the right time is very important. So therefore, I think it is a very important thing that we are doing this stuff, and I am so pleased that this is there. For example, Ms. Gupta and several others should know that when there are 2,400 entries for an international world competition by the DHNL at Germany went up from all over the schools, all over the management school throughout the world, it was extremely important for us to inform you that it is the first prize of £25,000, second prize of £15,000, and the third prize among the 2,400 entries were won by the Great Lakes students in an international meet. And I think Lalita and others should be so proud to see how our students can effectively communicate a very important concept and win the whole thing. So please let us invite Ms. Gupta to honor this release of communication as a communication legend. So you will get a copy of this. Symbolically, this will be there, and many such sequences of this will be periodically coming to talk about us all over the place. As a matter of fact, when I went for some of the alumni meets in Bangalore, Hyderabad, and Bombay, right now many of the CEOs are getting this kind of a communication magazine, and that is now putting us on the world map. So therefore, keep the good job doing. God bless you. Jai Hind. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for inviting me. And I have to say that I was here on a curiosity trip. Very often, and particularly recently, I've met Professor Sriram very frequently. We are working on a marketing summit for CII. We are just collaborating. And I just decided to come out and take a drive instead of sitting in my office and meeting clients. And then I got roped in into this. But actually, just looking at all of you, I'm so glad I got roped in into this. So thank you. I'm going to just take 10 minutes, and I'm not going to speak too much about the subject. I'm really going to share something which might be of relevance to you. And of course, the subject is of relevance, but when at this age, I think at this stage in your lives, perhaps you're really looking at the ceiling before you want to break it, right? So let me start by, because I'm, you know, somebody was before me who was a great storyteller. I think she's just amazing, Radhika. She was just fabulous storyteller. Well, let me tell you a lovely thing that happened, a small story that happened to me 2 months ago. I have two sons who are probably older than some of you here. And one of them is. And we were, and my husband and I, we are outdoors people. Once a year, we try to take a holiday together as a family. And we went to Tibet. Every year, we try to go to the mountains. My thinking is, while my bones are still working, let me go to the mountains and trek. So what really happened was I was reading a book, and as I put the book down in December last year, I said, we're going to Kailash. We're going to Kailash, Mount Kailash, those of you who might know of it. And it's a ruddy, difficult trek. It's 3 days, and the last time I went to 18,000 feet was 20 or 15 years ago when I tried, and I did get to base camp of Everest. But this, at this stage in my life, I was stupid enough to say we're going. And the thing is, once you've committed yourself, then you have to do it. And we did it, we planned, we did a bit of training, a little more than we were doing normally. But I'm very proud to say that we pinned the goal, and then we planned the strategy, and then we executed that plan in our lives for those 3 weeks. And first time I got 3 weeks off, man, I was really pleased. So no BlackBerry. That was the better part, right? I pretended it didn't work, though I must tell you, Chinese telecom is very good. Most of the time it worked. And we went and we did that 3 days, and for my husband and me, 11 hours of walking at that altitude. So I was quite miserable for those 3 days. And I was telling myself, what a fool. I could have been sitting in a 5-star hotel. But it was the most amazing and life-changing experience for me. I normally come back once a year. 3 years we went to Ladakh in a row. And I normally come back, you know, completely charged up, and really I'm quite a pain in the office after that for the next few months. By the way, the average age, I forgot to mention, in my office is 27-30. Okay? Advertising, as you know, is a young profession, and though probably the me and the 3 or 4 of us are the only people who tilt the average. So we're probably really the prehistoric. But you know, unfortunately for them, I'm worse than them. So we came back, and we really created a lot of change and chaos in the office right now. But what I really wanted to tell you was that when I came down and my son had my phone, he was using it, and he found a message saying very urgent. And I don't know if you know about an award that is the highest award in our business. It's at Cannes, CAN as they call it. And I prefer to say Cannes, okay?